الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم ما بعد. أيها الأحباب, from amongst the characteristics that Shaykh al-Islam ibn al-Qayyum rahimahullah ta'ala he mentioned, we reach the eighth characteristic, which is al-ghira. Ghira meaning a type of vigilant concern or jealousy. And we talked about hasad before, and we'll talk very briefly about the difference between hasad and ghira. Ghira, ayyuhal ahbab, generally is more of a positive attribute. But Ibn al-Qayyum explains that, rahimahullah ta'ala, that it can have opposing aspects of ghira. A lack of ghira or excessive ghira, excessive jealousy or what have you, which can go beyond the bounds of the Sharia. And we're going to talk about him as Shaykh al-Islam mentions him, rahimahullah ta'ala. But ayyuhal ahbab, the difference predominantly we want to state between ghira and hasad. Ghira, ayyuhal ahbab, is the type of jealousy or vigilant concern that a person has, for example, for their family or their loved one, or the boundaries of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that they're concerned for it. They have a love for it, or love for them, their family, and they want to protect them, and it's a type of jealousy that you don't want someone disrespecting your wife, for example, and looking at her and causing her harm. And likewise, ayyuhal ahbab, or on the other hand, in opposition to, is al-hasad. Hasad is where you have the type of jealousy to where you want the benefit of someone else to be removed. So in that same scenario, if it had to do with your spouse, for example, the woman or the man who wants his spouse some blessings to be taken away from them out of hasad, out of a kind of evil jealousy. They're jealous that they have this blessing, this benefit. Maybe your family has just come into wealth and you become jealous of that wealth. Why does she just inherited this? Why does she have that? I want that myself. I want that to be taken away from her. This individual may even want them to lose that wealth or be harmed in order that they do not benefit from that wealth. وَعِيَهَذَا مِلَّا مِنْ ذَلَكَ. That's the example of hasad. Whereas ghira is actually a more positive attribute generally, where it is more that you have a jealousy that you want that your family or something to be protected. So in that same example, where you would want to protect your wife and you want to protect your wife's property, that is the difference between ghira and hasad. Ayyuhal ahbab, Shaykh al-Islam rahimahullah ta'ala said regarding the ghira, he said ghira or vigilant concern has its limit, and if it exceeds its limit, it becomes evil suspicion of someone who is innocent and undeserving of it. And if it falls short of it, its limit, it becomes negligence and the foundation for the acceptance of indecency. Ayyuhal ahbab, let's take a look at those two opposing aspects of ghira that Shaykh al-Islam is mentioning, rahimahullah ta'ala. The first example, he's saying where the individual is excessive in ghira. For example, the woman who's very suspicious of her husband. She's jealous, and it's a good jealousy, but then it goes beyond the bounds. She believes he's chatting on the internet. She believes he has a Facebook page, and he's doing this, and he's doing that, and he's connecting with women, and whatever, and having secret meetings. All of these kind of things. That is something sinful. Or vice versa, whether it be the man. The man, he believes this woman, she says she's going shopping, she's going with her friends, or whatever. But he's so jealous, he doesn't even allow her to ever go with her friends. And I know situations like this in certain countries where the men are so jealous, their wives are literally almost like a prisoner. Ayyuhal ahbab, this is true. So being balanced is not being excessive and not having a negative view or being pessimistic about one's spouse or one's or whatever the situation is, and going beyond the bounds, going beyond the limits, but rather being within the limits, having a healthy concern, and the man maintaining his family and also helping his family protect themselves from harm. So telling his wife not to be excessive in being in the marketplace and be excessive in visiting people, especially if they're bad company and stuff like this, but still allowing some room to breathe and some room to benefit themselves. And perhaps this can also be looked at within the cultural context too, because as we know that one of the qaida or rulings in the sharia, one of the principles, is that al-ada muhakkam, that the tradition of a people or a custom of a people also, if there's nothing from the Quran and nothing from the sunnah and the ijma and the other aspects of adilla or evidences for something, then we go to the custom of the people. And that, and a ruling is derived from that, meaning that it doesn't contradict the Sharia. For example, there's no strong and there's no very strong and convincing evidence about what denotes traveling in Islam. Meaning some of the madhabs and many of the scholars, they say it is so many miles, such and such miles, because, you know, or that it you know, they define it either by miles or by time. But really, when we look at all the examples of a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the athar of the Salaf, we see that there's no real limit in the Sharia for that. So then, as Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah says, and before him, I believe it's Imam Malik or one of the great imams, also held this view, which is first and foremost before Shaykh al-Islam, rahimahumullah jami'an, he said that this goes back to the custom of the people. That, for example, you going between city such and such and city such and such, if the people of that locality consider that to be traveling, then it's traveling. You're a traveler. Then you can do all the things that a traveler does as far as shortening the prayer and combining the prayers and things like this. But if, for example, so it's not restricted to distance. So ayyul ahbab, this, as far as the allowance for the family to go and maybe go and visit their friends and stuff, perhaps you could look at this in relation to your custom. Because Saudi Arabian life is not like American life. And the needs that we have is not like their needs. You know, we have a situation. In Saudi Arabia, they don't drive. The women are not allowed to drive. And the scholars, the great scholars of Ahlul Sunnah, do not, they say that it's impermissible for the Saudi women to drive in their country because of the situation of their country. But you could not make that fatwa applicable here in America. That this would not be applicable. And there's a need for women maybe to drive in this country. And women go to work and different things. And it's not the same structure of society and the culture. Very, very different. So you cannot apply that fatwa to the situation that we have here. Or in the UK or wherever. So ayyul ahbab, here, the ada, the custom of the people, has a place in Islam. So pertinent to that, as far as ghira and having jealousy, that this also perhaps would look, we might look at that those different issues under there, as we described before, to be looked at pertinent to the custom. Ayyul ahbab, the other situation that Ibn al-Qayyim mentioned with regard to ghira is the situation, is the other extreme, where individuals have no ghira, no jealousy. So they look at their, for example, his wife, and she is allowed to come in the house at any time of the day. She leaves early in the morning, she's not working, and she comes back at midnight. Ayyul ahbab, this would not be permissible no matter what the custom is. Because not knowing where one's spouse is and at all, and having no idea, and that she's running the streets, it's not like those other cultures, those and disbelievers who, especially the ones that allow their women are totally free to do whatever they please. She comes and goes, she shops, she does whatever she wants, whenever she wants, spends whatever she wants, as if that's freedom. But then she gets into harm, she gets into this, she falls prey to this, and he has no jealousy. Oh, you think you're going to come home before midnight tonight? Oh, you're not? Oh, you know, that's okay. Oh, you didn't even bother with calling? That's okay. Oh, you came home the next day? Oh, that, ayu al-ahbab, is not permissible in Islam. And that shows a lack of ghira. And the Prophet ﷺ spoke about the one who has no jealousy, that this is something deplorable. You know, this is something deplorable in the Sharia, that this person, they don't have any concern about what their wife is doing. Their wife is doing this. And the same with no ghira for the husband. He's, you know, chatting on the internet with these girls, and she has no jealousy. Ayyul Ahbab, no, that's not the situation that Islam has legislated for. So that is being to the other extreme, where they're totally careless and carefree in these matters. And we ask Allah the Almighty to protect us from all of these, the characteristics which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is displeased with. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with ikhlas, with tabat. Anything I said that was correct was from Allah. Anything I said that was incorrect was from myself and the shaitan. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.